Okay. Hi. Welcome to episode 26. It's Sunday, September 4th. Okay, I just put fuel in the chainsaw for the first time. Okay, so I'm committed. I'm going to start up the chainsaw. I'm going to start up the chainsaw for the first time, but the seals need to be worked in slowly. They need to be wetted in. You don't want to be running this chainsaw at full tilt when it's brand new. So I put some oil and some 50 to 1 in the Husky. I'm going to start it for the first time, and we're just going to let it run for an hour or so before I try out the mill. Okay, it's finally happening. It took a little while. I've just been scared. What can you say? Like, I've been living in fear. Anyway, let's get this going. Well, good day, everybody. It's Thursday, September 8th. Oh, listen to Squeaky. Squeaky! It's about 10 a.m. in the morning. So the mill, hey? Everybody wants to know about the mill. I might mill today. The Husqvarna is brand new chainsaw, so it needs to be idled for like hours and hours to ease in the seals. So I ran it for about 2 hours with just idling, so it should be okay, and I should be able to start milling. What else? I cleared this area. I flattened it. Squeaker! Squeaky. Squeaky. Well, that's Squeaky for you. Digger's all freaked out. He's having a good time. Anyway, where was I? Squeaker is so cute. I cleared out this area here. I've been digging out all the rocks and roots, which is quite significant, really. Like, look at all these rocks. Like a lot of rocks came out of this little area here. So I've been flattening this area. Digger's going on a rampage. I've been flattening this area as a guest tent spot. A couple of the squids are coming in a week or two overnight, so we're going to have a little acoustic jam, and I'm going to make a little cozy spot for them to pitch their tents. Consider how many roots came out of that little area. Like, you know, here's a pile of roots. It's quite a large pile of roots to burn. And you can hear Squeaker going in the background, knocking on wood. Anywho, so I don't know what to tell you. Tomorrow I'm going back to the city, hopefully look at some apartments, bring Eric out for the weekend. But today I really should start milling, but then again, I gotta finish this flat spot. Some of these rocks are crazy. This is useless video right now, isn't it? Nothing's really happening, right? Okay. Get back to you later. If you ever wondered how I move things that are heavier than me, including giant logs and rocks, I use a combination of physics and my surrounding environment. So in this case, I'm trying to move a rock that weighs way more than me. So what I've been doing is I pry it up a little bit and then I jam something in the hole. Pry it up a little bit more, jam something in the hole. I replace the underneath of the rock with things that I can move easier, like a smaller rock. So I've been working on this rock for about 2 days, trying to flatten this area for the campsite. So check it out, I'll show you what I mean. Pry that sucker up. Missed. Let's try again. Ah, jeez. Get under there. There we go. Couple more centimeters. We'll call that a victory for today. So you might hear a little. Well, the top clamp on this chainsaw mill doesn't tighten on the end of the blade because of the thickness of this bracket. So, of course, I'm sawing along and the blade moves over and touches this metal. And guess what? I totally dulled the blade. I ruined the chain, like, in the first 30 seconds. So, wow, didn't get very far. Yeah, the chainsaw really chewed that up. So, I gotta put in some kind of a shim or something, because it doesn't go tight enough on the end of the blade, so it slips and then it hits the bracket. But now I gotta get a new frickin' chain, or learn how to sharpen. Anyway, one step forward, two steps back. Let's cut it here, eh? And think real hard about what a blessing it is to be alive. We lost the queen a couple days ago. I lost my queen and my mom this year. And we've been out here and trying to get stuff done. But anyway, life is a blessing. So enjoy every second of it. Love to all you people. I'll keep trying to persevere. Okay? Who was the guy that pushed the rock all the way up the hill and at the end of the day it just rolled back down? Did it again the next day? Maybe this is some kind of form of Zeus's hell, but I'm not dead yet.